Hello and welcome to the computer lab. So in this video I'm going to show you how to create a PNG on your Mac for free using the built-in programs. Okay, so let's get started. So the first thing to understand is what is a PNG. PNG is an image with the background removed, so they can add this and layer this onto videos or other images and pictures and stuff like that. There used to be a couple of free online editors you could do this in, but we're going to use a program on the Mac that comes installed as part of the OS. So to give you an example of that, if I'm trying to put an image, say I'm working in iMovie, let's just move this across to the side. So I'm working in iMovie and I want to have a video running, which I've just got a sample one here. So this is just a picture of some people at a bar, a stationary camera, and I want to place something on top. Now I'm just going to place whatever image I've got on here. So say for example I want to drop a picture of a football on there. Let me just sort out the fit so you can see what it looks like. So the picture of the ball at the moment, with not cut out, obviously it's showing on the white stick, and that might be all very good. That's what I might be trying to do. But if I want just the ball on its own in that image, in that video, then I need to cut this white background out that's surrounding it. So I'll leave that one there for a second, and I'll just minimize iMovie so we can see what we've got. And I'll create the other image, the PNG, which is just a white ball there. Okay, so let's look at the program that does it. So right click on the image, open with, preview, just minimize a little bit. Okay, so now we've got our ball and you can see the white background on this image just defined there. So we need to go up to the top toolbar where it says show markup toolbar, click on that, and then go across on the markup toolbar and we need to just go across to the one that looks like the wand, which is the instant alpha. Click on the instant alpha. And now we need to left click on the mouse and drag on the bit that we don't want. So anything that goes red is what we're going to cut out, what we're going to delete. So I'm going to left click and drag. And as I left click and drag, I can go up and down my mouse and it will change the alpha key. So if I left click and drag, you notice it goes red and then let go. So now we've got the marching ants that are going around the outside of the actual image and also around the ball, which is what I want. So now I can delete by pushing command and delete key. Or if I go up to the edit menu, I can also do cut, which again is command and X, or I can just go down the menu and click on cut, and this will cut out anything that was highlighted red. So now it's going to ask us, it's going to convert this image to a PNG. So it's important to note this bit, this is actually going to convert the image and change your original image. So you notice at the moment I've got a JPEG, and now it's going to change that actual file to a PNG. So if you don't want to destroy the original, it's worth making a copy before you go to this stage. So if you don't want to do that and you want to make a copy, obviously, because it's going to destroy it, so right click and just duplicate your image so you've got a copy of it, then go back to the one that we're working on here. So I'll just quickly go through what we did again. So we're all selected still. Our instant alpha is still selected. Left click, drag, gone red, let go, marching ants, up to edit, up to cut. It's going to convert it and you'll see this image here, this JPEG file, it'll go to a PNG. And there we go. So football on white background has now changed to a PNG. So it's not going to be a white background. Obviously we need to rename the file, but I'll keep this video moving along. So this is the image now that we've got. So I'll just minimize that one now. Back into our iMovie. So this was what the original image looked like. So now we can drag our new one in, a PNG, drop it into the file, and I'll just extend it out a bit, just get it sorted out so we can see what we're doing. We'll put that one in the same position so you can see the difference straight away. Obviously we have the one with the white background, and then as soon as we get to this one here we have the ball, which is with the background cut out. So that's all very good, and it works really good when you've got contrasting colours between the two things that you're trying to cut out. So if you're in control of that, then it's worth taking the picture on something that has a contrasting background. To give you an example of that, I've taken a couple of pictures here. So as you can see in the video, the best way to tech it is to get the contrasting color between what you're taking a photo of and against the background. So for example, this is an image of a memory card that we took. So if I right click, open with preview. So this is the image now that we've got. So I'll just spin it around. So here we need to get rid of all the wood. Because the wood is a very similar color to the actual card itself, it can get confusing for the alpha. So it's obviously trying to remove colors that you predefine by selecting. So if I go to my markup toolbar, click on the instant alpha tool again, to rev our image, so as I left click and drag, you see it's going red, and it, depending on where I pick in the image, will be to define how it's going to try and cut out. So I can try and pick different bits up. And I'm trying to leave the black in the middle. And you can see as I'm going through, it's struggling leaving bits on. So if I cut that out now, go to edit and cut. It's going to convert it. And it leaves these extra bits of wood, which I can get rid of by just highlighting, and keeping the same tool selected, highlighting, and then deleting, and just doing each bit individual. Obviously, to try and keep things quick, you need to try and get that contrasting color. So get rid of that one for a minute. And I took another picture on the desk against a white background. So let's open that one up. Open with preview. Spin it around so we can see what we're doing. So you can see the contrasting colors. This is the white paper, obviously, and this is just the background of the preview. So again, markup tool, across to instant alpha, down to the bit that I want to cut out, put my cursor on it, left click and drag. Wait for it to go red. If we're happy with it all red, I can let go. Click on edit. Click on cut. It's going to convert it to a PNG. And then straight away you can see the difference. It's got rid of all the colours and surrounding colours. And now we can then use them a lot better. So if I look for the pictures that we did. So the picture on the desk, this is the converted one. That's the one that was on the actual paper. And you see it's taking it really clean cut, really nice. And this one, it's taking it, but it's left all the bits of the wood in. So that's it. That's how to convert a JPEG into a PNG on your Mac for free. I hope this video has been helpful. If it has, please do hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to be alerted to any new videos. And all comments are always appreciated underneath the video. Thanks again for watching at the Computer Lab.